What we have here is the 300 watt version of the FlexGURU Flex ATX PSU from the brand FSP. So, full transparency, up until maybe last year, I had no idea what Flex PSUs are. I had thought that SFX was the smallest PSU form factor that existed for consumer level products. That may have been true a while back, but as we can see here, that is no longer the case. This form factor, which I believe is also called 1U, has been used in server rack applications, since there is a very limited space in a server rack. Space that obviously will not fit ATX PSUs. Now, since I have decided to build an SFF or small form factor rig, I have looked into the different case options and also found out that you can indeed really go small in terms of case capacity, and that an SFX PSU can technically still be called large if compared to something like this. This is why I got myself this PSU from FSP. Unfortunately, there's not a lot of branded options available here locally in the Philippines when it comes to this product, at least when I tried to search for it online. It's a good thing that this model from FSP is available even through e-commerce options. There's one big disappointment though with this product, which I'll explain later on. For now, let's proceed with the unboxing. Looking at all sides of the box, there isn't really much to see. Here at the back, what should be noted is, aside from the missing distributor sticker, which I hope is not a red flag, is a distribution of the connectors. Logically, since the actual area and volume of Flex PSUs are smaller, it won't be able to accommodate as many connections as your usual ATX PSUs. This specific model actually won't be able to power a GPU that needs 8-pin or 6-pin power. We'll take a look at that later on the PSU itself and the included cables. The thing I am not happy about is this 90 plus indication on the box. It should be very clear that 90 plus or any other VIG certification that is not 90 plus should be dismissed or ignored. FSP, though possibly not yet at the levels of Corsair, Seasonic, EVGA and the likes, is an already known brand of PSUs. They are fairly reliable, at least based on what I know and have experienced, so it's a little bit disappointing to see this kind of quote-unquote deception on the product. There's a newer version of this particular model though, that seems to be already 80 plus gold certified. I just wish they already discontinued this version, or pulled out the existing units of this older model from their suppliers. Inside the box, we find the instruction manual. In this plastic bag, we have the mounting accessories, namely the bracket and some screws. Next is this bunch of cables secured with a Velcro strap. Let's look at the connector distribution later on. So aside from the PSU, there seems to be nothing else inside the box. Let's set this aside and check out the PSU. On this side will be the sticker or the label that contains the technical specifications. And on this side, we have the 40mm fan as well as the two, or I should say three, connections or ports on the PSU. One is a 10-pin, while the other is a 14-pin, with the smaller 8-pin on the side. Why it is distributed in this particular way, I honestly do not know. But again, we have to consider that there is limited space here. By the way, this model doesn't come with the actual power cable that plugs in into your power outlet. Now, let's look at the included cables. There are actually only two of them, with a whole lot of daisy chaining happening. Here we have the 10-pin one, which on the other end terminates a total of 4 SATA power connectors, 2 Molex connectors, as well as to this floppy disk power connector. I'm not sure if that is an indicator of how old this model is, but I definitely will not be needing that. The other one would be the 14-pin that terminates with the 20+4-pin and 4+4-pin connectors for the motherboard and CPU power. We also have here the mentioned small 8-pin connector that I guess provides supplemental power for the motherboard. As you have already seen on the PSU and here on the cables, there isn't really an option for powering PCIe devices. This means that your options for using a discrete graphics card would be severely limited, with the latest ones being the GTX 1650 from NVIDIA, the RX 6400 from AMD, and the ARC A380 from Intel. If you ask me, this 300W version of the FlexGURU PSU would be more appropriate for APU or integrated graphics builds, while the 500W version being more apt for builds using a discrete graphics card. So that is it for this unboxing of the FlexGURU FlexATX PSU 300W version from FSP. If you like this video, click on that like button and consider subscribing to my channel for more unboxings and other videos like this. By the way, watch out for my SFF build video, which as I mentioned will make use of this particular PSU. Thank you for watching, and as always, see you again in my next video.